That's the trick of this kind of show, is you need somebody who the audience is going to want to come back with to hang out with every week. And when I saw Natasha's work in Russian Doll and had become friends with her, I realized she's got that charisma. It's just a thing. You just want to hang out with her, man.
We're here with Rian Johnson, creator and executive producer of the new Peacock series, Poker Face. Rian, welcome. Thank you for talking to us.
Thanks for having me.
From the production value to the writing to the acting, cast, just all across the board, it was like, I felt like I was watching a condensed version of a theatrical Knives Out-esque experience. What lessons and sensibilities maybe did you bring from your experience in that franchise when creating and producing Poker Face?
Well, I mean, the easy answer is we brought a lot of the same people. My cinematographer, Steve Yedlin, worked with me on the episodes I directed, but also Jaron Prasant, who we've worked with, was one of our other DPs. But then some new folks, Christina Ng was our other DP. I didn't approach it differently than I approach my movies. And I kind of embraced the whole thing and dove into it as if it were one of my films and tried to give it the same care and the same level of craftsmanship I give to my movies.
Could you point to maybe two or three games that may have affected your creative process or served as an inspiration when you made Poker Face or even before in your career?
When I was a teenager, the computer games I was playing were Infocom games. And those were the text-based adventures where it was like Zork and Planetfall. But there were a couple of those games that were mysteries. I'd throw people back to old Infocom mysteries. And then there were others kind of like as I was growing up that went into the murder mystery. So I don't know, anytime games kind of like veer into the mystery element. I liked L.A. Noir. I don't know if you played L.A. Noir, but I really enjoyed that game with the element of like questioning people and looking at their facial expressions.
One of the things that, you know, you can't go without talking about is just Natasha Lyonne. So she plays Charlie.
I have this thing. I can tell if someone's lying. I mean, it's a whole thing. It would take too long to explain.
She kind of has a sixth sense where she can tell people are lying. If Charlie Kale and Benoit Blanc had to face off, who do you think would solve a murder mystery faster?
I think they would work as a perfect team. And although I can't promise, mostly for legal reasons with Netflix and Peacock, that will happen. Highly doubtful, but I have a feeling they would work as a perfect team and be pretty unstoppable. So with this character, and I think this does have something in common with Benoit Blanc in that she has a moral center. And she has a genuine curiosity about people. She likes people in this show. Charlie does.
There's something off here. There's a lie. I need to find it.
And that's the trick of this kind of show, is you need somebody who the audience is gonna wanna come back with to hang out with every week. And I think the natural sharpness of Natasha combined with a genuinely sunny character, I mean, those two come together, it's like chocolate and peanut butter.
Aside from the really stellar performance of Natasha Lyonne, every episode sets up just like a murderer's row of guest stars. You have Adrian Brody, you have Ellen Barkin, you have Tim Meadows, you have just the list goes on and on. If you could have like two people, maybe three people that you would definitely want for season two of Poker Face, do you have anybody top of mind?
I mean, there are so many. I'm always hesitant because I don't want to jinx it. I'll tell you, man, if I can pull my old friend Jamie Lee Curtis into one of these, I would be thrilled. Also because her first job was in a Columbo episode. So it ties into Knives Out too. So if I can somehow convince JLC to come in for one of these, I'd be a happy man. I mean, when I knew that part of the joy of this was going to be the guest stars that we're going to get, the Hal Ketchum format, as opposed to like Knives Out as a whodunit, where there's a group of suspects, which one of them did it, blah, blah, blah. And so what that meant to me is we can really write a great part for these guest stars and let them truly be the guest star of the episode. They can really own the episode.
When I watched the show, I felt like it was kind of Case of the Week meets Prestige TV. Is that a fair way to describe it, do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's definitely trying to bring back the Case of the Week episodic vibe. I kind of missed the old school thing of you can sit down and just watch an hour of TV and you're going to get an entire story and it's going to spit you out at the end of it like, yes. You don't have to watch the entire season to do it. You can just skip ahead and watch it if you want. I mean, that sounds, I don't know, that sounds like freedom to me.